So the first step in this process is to open up a document. Now this is only a test document, you'll use your own document of course. So let's start with a new document, doesn't matter what it is, 1024 by 768. Simply the first one that comes up. That's all we want is a blank screen. There we go. Now I'll just reduce that in size a bit so we can actually see what we've got. Now the first thing I want to do is draw a rectangle. So now we have our rectangle. Now, we don't put any text in this to start with. What we do is go up to the top here and convert to curves. Now you can see that that's a curve. If we go to there and you look in there, you can see it says curve. Now that's what we want. Now the next thing is we're going to put some text in there. So just tap on that artistic text tool. And put in there, Arial. Let's make it a nice font. Get my keyboard out the way. We'll call it the Acme Secret Agent. 48 point, that's fairly large. Uppercase, MORCCO, Morocco. That's all we want. Now, I'm not going to do fancy things with the text. That's all we need at the moment. So, back to there. Select that. Now, we've got Morocco in the middle, and you think, well, artistic text. Okay, what good is that? No good at all. So, let's select that. Because that's not how we do it. Let's get rid of that altogether. Select the artistic text tool. Now, we just place the point of your pen. There we go. Now, it can be quite tricky on the iPad. You just hold the point of your pen on the line of the box. Now, you can see it's changed to curve path text. Now, if we type in, we've got Acme Secret Agent, regular, 1.7 points. We need it larger than that. We need it 45. Click OK. There we go. Now it's 45 point text. It's big enough to see. Make it capitals, MORCCO, Morocco, and it's about the center. Now, we change that location by doing that. That's about the center. Move tool. We can draw that down. Now if we go back to there, you can see that line. There we go. Now that's snapping is on and it's snapped to the center. That's just what we want. See the node tool? I've just tapped the node tool and the points have changed to clear. If I go to move tool, you can see the points in the corner there. I can move that up, and that's where I want it. Now we change the node tool. Now the trick here with the node tool is don't grab the corner handles. That's a big mistake. We want to curve the Morocco down. So you draw the top bar up, and draw the bottom bar up. Now, if that rectangle is too big, we've got to reduce it in size. But that's what we've got there at the moment. Let's grab the Art Text tool and just use the green cube. It still thinks it's centered, but it's not quite centered. There we go. It's following the Art Text tool. There's the nodes. Now, if you grab the corners, you end up with all sorts of strange things that you can't with any ease modify. But that's all right. You can experiment with that. What we've got there now is turn off selection. You've got the word Morocco moved. Now, where's our... There we go. It's all selected again. And see what happens when I move those in? It's really sliding that about. Now, this is using the using Designer. Put that up there, deselect everything, and you've got Morocco there. Now, you can do this part in Designer or switch to Photo and use Photo. But what I'm going to do is go back here, select Home is where the pet, Home is where my pets are, which is probably not appropriate, but still, make a copy of that, go back here, go back to Morocco, and paste. Now, there's nothing we can do with that at the moment, not in Designer. So we're going to move the whole thing to Photo. So we go here, save a copy, and call this one Morocco for Photo. Click Save. Morocco for Photo, put that in Designer, that's fine, that's where I want it, save. And now we can hop out of that and we'll move over to Photo. That's the next part of our process. Now, here we are in Affinity Photo. This is the second half of the exercise, if you like. Remember, we just saved the first document, excuse me, in Affinity Designer. And it had the bent Morocco word in it, and I'd loaded in a transparent image. Now we'll go find that. The good thing about this, Morocco for Photo, that's the one we saved, and there it all is there. There's the, let's get that over there so we can see that, the move tool, so we can see what layer we're on. There's the Morocco layer, and there's the home layer. Now, it's got a little bit of work in it, but we're in Photo. So what you do with Photo, we've got the home. We want to bend that. So you need the filter and you need, let's go down and find it, the mesh warp tool. Did you see that? LM mesh warp tool, right there. Now you can see that in the destination, editing source, show the mesh. Now it's just a square and it works the same way as we just did. You hold on to the bar and drag that down and you can drag that up and you can pinch that and you can move that about. Don't forget to go apply. Otherwise, if you just go back and do something else, you lose the movement. Let's do that again. Mesh warp, and there's the tool. It's still warped from the first time. Let's squeeze that down and apply. And there it is there. So we've got Morocco and home is where my pets are. Now that's a transparent image and that's really very simple. The reason we're doing it in Photo is that excuse me again, you can't do that mesh warp tool in Designer, but you can do the text in Designer. You can bend the text, but not the design. Now, that looks very odd. I mean, that's not even good design there. I've just squished it up so you can see what's happening. Let's go and have a look at something else that I've done that shows you the same thing. I've gone over here and I've created this one. Now there's a photo of a Moroccan street. There's the move tool highlighted. Remember, we're still in photo, so I can see the word Morocco and it's bent. And squared off there is the image of the Moroccan street. Now, you may not want that quite that shape. You may want it another shape. A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M. There's the mesh warp tool, and you can see the little tags on the corners turn transparent. And I want to move that a little bit more. Let's move it in there. And there it is. Don't forget to tap apply. Now there's a nice design shape and the word Morocco in it. And that's all there is to it. Thanks for watching this little exercise.